Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hopkinton High School as we have Hopkinton Hillers softball for you on HCAM. It is senior night for the Hopkinton Hillers softball team. They come in to this game with a 17-1 record, and today they will take on the Holliston Panthers, who are 8-10 on the season. Tom Nappy on the call, Bob Hamilton on camera. It is a beautiful day for softball here at Hopkinton High School, and all around the stadium you can see various designs honoring the seniors for this Hopkinton Hillers team. But the Hillers certainly hoping that there is a lot more season left as they look to make a postseason push. They are already in, that's for sure, but now it's just the fight for seeding, trying to rack up those home matchups in the playoffs, and the more wins, the more home games you will get. And today they look to add another victory to the slate, as the Hillers have just really been unstoppable all season long behind the pitching of Juliet Hulme, and of course the bats of a number of different Hillers, including Kayla Sullivan, who has 5 home runs leading the league, Lizzy Kelley, Kate Welzel, Jenna Bogan. Just a stacked lineup as we are set for softball. Stepping up first to the plate for the Holliston Panthers, it's Grace DeZendelet, the shortstop, in just a moment. We'll get you the entire Holliston lineup as they huddle up on the mound here on senior night for the Hopkinton Hillers softball team. Let's take a look at the Holliston Panthers lineup. Grace DeZendelet will lead things off and bat first. Heather Ledger will bat second and play center field. Batting third is the pitcher Shannon Murphy. Playing second base and in the cleanup role is Caroline Werner. As Hulme just about set to deliver. Then batting fifth is the left fielder Abby Ray Wells. As Hulme to the set. And the first pitch is going to be low. Kate Healy is the first baseman, batting sixth for the Panthers, as that pitch is called a strike. Elena Ferrero is the catcher, batting seventh. Hannah Brady is batting eighth and playing right field. Batting ninth is the third baseman, Shannon Rogan. There's a swinging strike. A 1-2 count on Grace DeZendelet. The field for the Hopkinton Hillers, Juliet Hume's battery mate is Lizzy Kelley behind the plate. And she has just been so solid behind home plate all season long. And there is a swinging strike, one down. Jenna Bogan is over at first base. Molly Bennett, the second baseman. Kate Welzel, the shortstop. Nicole Comeau, the third baseman. From left to right, Kayla Sullivan, Hanna Engstrom, and Renee Cooprider. As Heather Ledger steps up to the plate to face Juliet Hulme, who has a .12 ERA this season. As there's a strike. Leading the league, she has been nearly unhittable. The only runs she has given up all season long was to coach Dennis Baker Sr.'s Bellingham Blackhawks, as the bunt attempt is strike two. And of course, a very good team in Bellingham. We'll get you the standings in just a moment, but it's really Hopkinton, Bellingham, and Norton at the top of the TVL, and that was a liner right to the Holliston dugout area, and that actually got a piece of the hitter on deck. So we certainly hope that she's okay. Looks like it got a piece of Shannon Murphy right in the arm. So she's going to shake it off and hopefully be able to stay in the game. Hume delivers, and that pitch is just inside. A 1-2 count on Heather Ledger. The Holliston Panthers led by head coach Jen Picardo, the Hopkinton Hillers, Dennis Baker Jr. And there is a swinging strike, K number two for Hume.
Come on, Murph.
If this keeps up in the highlights, we might have that pitch counter back, the Juliet Hume strikeout counter, rather. First two batters go down with K's. Shannon Murphy will step to the plate. Hume to the set, delivers up high. A 1-0 count on Murphy. Hume set the deal. And this is hit in the air, a little bloop shot, and it'll be handled by the third baseman, Nicole Comeau. And that will be it for the Holliston Panthers on the top of the first. They go down 1-2-3, the Hopkinton Hillers coming up. Bottom half of the first inning, the Hopkinton Hillers coming up to the plate. Let's take a look at the Hillers lineup. They are going to start things off with center fielder Hanna Engstrom, and then batting second will be the right fielder Renee Cooprider. Batting third is the catcher Lizzy Kelley, and the cleanup role is Kayla Sullivan, who has just been outstanding for the Hopkinton Hillers. She's playing left field today. Kate Welzel, the shortstop, batting fifth. Jenna Bogan, the first baseman, batting sixth. Juliet Hume, the pitcher, batting seventh. Nicole Comeau is batting eighth and playing third base. Colleen Mitchell, batting ninth. She's the designated player. Odd man out of the lineup is second baseman Molly Bennett. Let's take a look at the Holliston Panthers diamond. Shannon Murphy is the pitcher. Aiden Fierro is the catcher. At first base, it is Kate Healy. And over at second base, it is Caroline Shannon. Over at shortstop, Grace DeZendelet. Third base, Shannon Reagan. From left to right, Abby Ray Wills. Heather Ledger in center, and Hannah Brady is the right fielder. And just a correction on the second baseman. It is Caroline Werner playing second base for the Holliston Panthers, as the Hillers are set to come up to the plate after a 1-2-3 inning by Juliet Hume. And besides the miraculous pitching of Juliet Hume, you look at the Hillers lineup and they lead the league in quite a few categories. A very good lineup for this Hopkinton Hillers team. And we'll get you some stats in just a moment as we take a look at Shannon Murphy warming up for the Holliston Panthers. And this season, she's been a pretty good young sophomore pitcher for the Panthers, so they perhaps have their starter for the next couple of years. And Shannon Murphy this season is 4-2, a 3.16 ERA, and 13 appearances on the mound, also has a save to her credit. As Hanna Engstrom set to step up. Oh, and actually they switched pitchers out there for the Holliston Panthers. And Shannon, their starter, was the pitcher that got hit in the arm, and they had to take her out of the game. It's Aaron Kerr on the mound for the Holliston Panthers. So a quick switch up, and she's a freshman. So she'll get some good experiences here against this Hopkinton Hillers lineup. A 2-0 count on Hanna Engstrom. Now, if you remember in the first inning, as that's fouled away, Shannon Murphy took a foul ball right off the arm, and she was pulled from her start here today. So Aaron Kerr out there for the Holliston Panthers. As that pitch is up high. Aaron Kerr is a freshman, a 3.77 ERA on the season, 1-5 in 11 appearances. There's a swinging strike. Showing off some good stuff there. A high-rising fastball. Engstrom, a 345 hitter on the season. And there's strike three. Renee Cooprider will come up to the plate. Eight seniors for the Hopkinton Hillers celebrating senior day here today at the Hillers softball diamond. As that pitch is just high, 1-0. And those seniors include Renee Cooprider, Lizzy Kelley, Kayla Sullivan, Colleen Mitchell, Hanna Engstrom, Nicole Comeau, as that is fouled away. Jenna Bogan and Juliet Hulme. And it is going to be a pretty sizable transition losing those eight players. Some very impressive talent, but the Hillers certainly have a lot of good talent up in the works as that pitch is high and over the head of the catcher. And if you do look at some of the players that'll be back, of course, one of the key players that'll be back is Bree Mirabli, who is likely going to be the Hillers starter next season as this gets by the glove of first baseman Kate Healy. And Cooprider is aboard with a single. So a little single right up the line, and that'll bring up Lizzy Kelley to face Aaron Kerr, the pitcher for the Holliston Panthers. And Shannon Murphy is standing over in the dugout area, the original starter for Holliston. She took a foul ball off the arm in the top of the first. It looks like she's rubbing that arm over there. She does have some ice that she's been putting on it, so we'll see if she ends up getting into the game as there's a strike. As Lizzy Kelley steps back into the box and awaits the pitch. And this is a little bloop shot foul. No one is able to get there in time, 0-2. And this is, it's an unfortunate circumstance on how you get this experience, but good experience here for the freshman, Aaron Kerr, for the Holliston Panthers to face a lineup like this. Is that pitch up high, 1-2. Better talent you play, the faster you'll get better. As Lizzy Kelley steps back in and awaits the pitch. And she hits this to left field, and it's off the glove of Abby Ray Wells. That'll drop in, and the run is going to try to come home. The throw in is going to get by Aiden Fierro, and Lizzy Kelley advances to third. So Renee Cooprider comes around to score the first Hillers run, and I think you got to give the error out there on that play. It was a tough ball to grasp, but it was in the webbing of the glove, so you got to pull that in. So Lizzy Kelley reaches, Cooprider scores, and now Kayla Sullivan will come up to the plate. Wind up and the pitch is in there for a strike. That's a good momentum shift for the Hillers. It looked like Aaron Kerr was going to get the big out with Lizzy Kelley. This is on the ground, up the middle, that'll get through, and another Hillers run will score. Kayla Sullivan with an RBI single. Now a 2-0 game as Kate Welzel will come up to the plate. Bree Mirabli also got a pair of starts for the Hillers on the road as that pitch outside. And she actually qualifies for the league leaders in pitching stats because she has pitched in 9 games as there is a strike. So she's actually second in the TVL for ERA with that .48 as this is hit in the air towards the fence and over the glove of right fielder Hannah Brady. Brady throws it in, and it is going to get past the pitcher's circle. No one got to it, but the runners will stay put. So Kayla Sullivan moves up to third, and Welzel safe at second with the double, and that'll bring up Jenna Bogan.
Come on, D.
And that was, looked like it was getting higher as it was heading towards right field, went right over the head of Hanna Brady. And I'm sure it probably got a little push from the wind as well, as there's a strike. It is an absolutely gorgeous day here. Sunny in the 80s, slight wind, as this is on the ground foul third base side. 0-2. Topkington Hillers softball senior night. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. A 2-0 lead for the Hillers in the bottom of the first, as that's tipped foul. The HCAM Weather Center reads 88 degrees, clear skies, a 2-mile-an-hour southeast wind. As this is a liner right to the shortstop, a nice snag by Dezendelet for the second out of the inning. That'll bring up Juliet Hulme. So two outs now. Still two runners in scoring position for the Hillers. Hulme at a 263 mark on the season, as that pitch is just outside. She's hit in 12 games. She's scored 7 times, driven in 3. Pretty good bat as well as a pitcher, and she hits this into left field. That'll drop in for a hit. One Hillers run around a score, and the second will come around as the throw is cut off by the shortstop. A 2-RBI single for Juliet Hulme, and it is 4-0 Hillers. That'll bring up Nicole Comeau. So the rally continues, and the Hillers, they've done a lot of damage this season with two outs. As that pitch is up high, 1-0. Just when you think that you're going to get out of the inning clean, the Hillers don't make it very easy for you. On the ground, up the middle, it took a hop over the pitcher's head to throw to first in time. And they will get the 4-3 ground out for the third out, but not before the Hopkinton Hillers plate 4 runs and lead 4-0 heading into the second. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Cornerstone at Milford, a new senior community featuring apartment living with innovative programs, services, and transportation to help seniors stay independent, conveniently located on Route 109 near 495. More at cornerstonemilford.com as we are set for the second inning, as the Hillers huddle up in the pitcher's circle with a comfortable 4-0 lead. And stepping to the plate for Holliston is Caroline Werner. Werner, the second baseman today for Holliston, set to face Juliet Hulme, who already has 2 strikeouts to her credit. And that pitch inside. Also due up for Holliston this inning is Abby Ray Wells and Kate Healy. Hulme to the set. And this is hit in the air, foul. 1-1. Caroline Werner, a freshman, a 295 batting average on the season. There's a strike. 1-2. She has scored 10 runs, driven in 4. This Holliston team, a pretty young team. And there is strike 3, third strikeout for Hulme. I'll bring up Abby Ray Wells. Only 3 seniors on the Holliston roster. To the set, the bunt, and that is going to roll foul. Nice job by Lizzy Kelley waiting that one out. And besides the 3 seniors on the roster, only 5 juniors, so a lot of sophomores and freshmen. As that bunt is going to be called foul. Little tip there. Hulme is set to deal. And this is hit in the air to left field and caught. Two away as Sullivan gets under that one. That'll bring up Kate Healy. Kate Healy, a junior, a 2-11 on the season. Has scored twice, driven in four. Hume set to deal. This is hit in the air, a little bloop shot to center. Engstrom tracks it down and makes the catch. Another 1-2-3 inning for the Hopkinton Hillers. We head to the bottom of the second. Hillers up 4-0. Bottom half of the second inning, and due up for the Hillers is hitter number 9, Colleen Mitchell, the designated player. Hanna Engstrom and Renee Cooprider also due up this inning as the Hillers went through 8 hitters in the bottom half of the first and drove in 4 runs. A 2-RBI single by Juliet Hulme. Drove in Sullivan and Welzel to make it 4-0 as this pitch is strike 1. Kerr to the set. Aaron Kerr making a spot start today as that pitch is fouled away and nearly a nice snag by a fan. And Aaron Kerr, a freshman for Holliston, making the start after Shannon Murphy in the first inning took a foul ball off the arm. That pitch up high. 1-2. Colleen Mitchell, a senior, 250 hitter on the season, as that pitch outside. And over the last few games, Coach Baker Jr. has had the opportunity to kind of switch up the lineup a little bit, get some hitters some more experience in the lower spots. There's strike 3. That'll bring up Hanna Engstrom. And he also made it so it's a senior-riddled lineup today, as it is senior day for the Hillers. Is that pitch inside, 1-0 on Engstrom. All 8 seniors are in the lineup today. That pitch up high. The lineup and the pitch. And that is a little foul tip, 2-1. Engstrom struck out in the first inning. That was followed up by a Renee Cooprider single, and then Lizzy Kelley reached on an errant catch attempt by the left fielder, Abby Ray Wells. And then Kayla Sullivan drove her in with a single, as that pitch outside. Then Welzel hits a double to put Sullivan on third. And then Hulme with the 2-RBI single. Kerr delivers, hit in the air, foul, third base side out of play, 3-2. Kerr awaits the sign and deals. Foul tip. Engstrom just barely getting a piece of that one. Engstrom has driven in 13 runs, scored 21 herself, and is hitting a 345. That is hit foul behind the backstop. Count remains full. And how about this? The Hillers have scored 176 runs this season as a team. And considering that is through 18 games, that is quite impressive. This is hit in the air, foul on the third base side, and no one will get to it. It's right over near the fence on the third base side. Abby Ray Wells, the left fielder, and Shannon Reagan rushed in to try to get to it. Kerr to the set. Hillers averaging 9.7 runs a game. Quite unbelievable. That pitch down low. Full count on Engstrom. And there's ball 4. Engstrom draws the walk, and that will bring up Renee Cooprider. to the set. Up high, and Engstrom taking off. The throw is a little bit too high from Aiden Fierro, and Engstrom has the stolen base. Nice job by Grace DeZendelet, preventing that from getting into the outfield. And this is a liner off the glove of the pitcher, and that'll get into center field. Engstrom being waved around. The throw is high, and the fifth hitter's run has scored. Renee Cooprider with the RBI hit to drive in Engstrom, and that will bring up Lizzy Kelley. I'm going to credit that an RBI single. She got the second on the throw in. Lizzy Kelley reached on an error as she lined it in the left field, and Ray Wells could not pull it down. She did drive in a run on that hit. That's up high. That was Engstrom's seventh stolen base of the year earlier. 7 for 7 stolen base attempts. That pitch inside. Right now, standing at second base is Renee Cooprider, who's also a threat to take off. She's 9 for 10 in stolen base attempts. That pitch is just inside. And how about the Hillers overall? A 4.35 on base percentage. That's unbelievable. And this is a liner right towards us. And certainly thought that one was heading for us. Wind up and the pitch. On the ground, up the middle. And it'll get by the glove of the second baseman. And the sixth Hillers run is waved around and will score. Lizzy Kelley with another RBI, and that'll drive in Cooprider. It looked routine, but Werner just not able to get there in time, so since there was no contact with the glove, I think you'd credit Kelley with the hit there. Kayla Sullivan at the plate awaits the pitch from freshman Aaron Kerr. There's a pitch up high, 1-0. And on Thursday, it is Baker Bowl Part 2 this week, and certainly have that game as well, as there's a swinging strike. Dennis Baker Jr. and the Hopkinton Hillers softball team will take on Dennis Baker Sr. and the Bellingham Blackhawks for the last game of the regular season here at the Hopkinton Softball Diamond. Is that pitch up high? And those games are always terrific showdowns. Bellingham, again, has a great team this year as well. A pitch up high. Kerr to the set, a liner right to the second baseman. Throw to first, they get two. Nice job by the second baseman, Caroline Werner. Picking up on the double play opportunity, and that is just pure bad luck there for Kayla Sullivan, but the Hillers do plate a couple more runs and lead 6-0 heading to the third. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Weston Nurseries, located at 93 East Main Street. Visit their garden centers in Hopkinton or Chelmsford and discover limitless possibilities to create your backyard paradise. Find them online at westonnurseries.com. We are set for the third inning, a 6-0 lead for the Hillers. Due up for Holliston, the 7, 8, and 9 hitters. Catcher Elena Ferrero, right fielder Hannah Brady, and the third baseman Shannon Rogan. Due up for Holliston to face Juliet Hulme, who has 3 strikeouts to her credit so far. 2-1-2-3 innings for the Hillers so far. Hulme to the set. Pitches inside. Twenty-seven. Hulme deals. There's a strike. One and one. Elena Ferrero, a senior, 273 on the season, has scored 7 runs. A pitch inside. She's driven in 5 for the 8-10 Holliston Panthers. Hulme delivers, that's fouled away. Went off the backstop and into the glove of Kelley, 2-2. To the set. That is foul behind the backstop. Count remains even.
Way to battle, Elena.
Hulme set to deliver. That is just outside. A full count. Wind up and the pitch, and this is hit in the air towards left field, towards the fence, and ranging back to make the catch is Kayla Sullivan for the first out of the inning. That was hit pretty far by Lana Ferrero. Got a good piece of that as Hanna Brady will come up to the plate. Hulme awaits the sign and deals. That is just low. Taking a look at the standings for TVL softball. The Hillers 17-1, 16-0 in the TVL at the top. Norton 15-2, 14-2 in the TVL. There's a strike. Of course, both their losses came to Hopkinton. And Bellingham in third, 13-3, 12-3 in the TVL. And one of their 3 losses came from Hopkinton, as we had that game for you on the road. That one's fouled away. 2-1. And then after that, you really just have a bunch of teams sitting around 500. Holliston 8-10, Westwood 8-10, Millis 9-9. And then it drops off from there. Medfield 7-11. That pitch down low. Medway 5-10, Dover Sherbourne and Ashland at the bottom, 2-14 overall. So it's pretty likely that there could be only 3 playoff teams from the TVL as that one's fouled away. But it has been a very competitive division. A lot of back and forth battles, especially from the teams sitting in the middle, just back and forth battles with each other. A lot of split series as that one's up top. Hulme is set to deliver. There is strike 3, 2 away. Shannon Rogan will come up to the plate. Hulme set to deal. Bunt attempt, and it's foul. Shannon Reagan, a junior. A 194 hitter. There's a strike, 0-2. Pretty good turnout here today for senior night. And a lot of Panthers fans making the trip down. Hulme deals, bunt pulled back, and that is strike 3. 2 straight strikeouts to end the 3rd inning for Juliet Hulme and the Hillers defense. We head to the bottom of the 3rd. Hillers leading this game 6-0. Set for the bottom of the 3rd inning, a 6-0 Hopkinton lead. Due up for the Hillers is the 5th, 6th, and 7th hitters. Kate Welzel, Jenna Bogan, and Juliet Hulme to face Erin Kerr out there for her 3rd inning of work. And the First pitch is strike one. Kerr to the set. On the ground, third base side, and it's past the reach of third baseman Shannon Reagan, and then bobbled in left field by Ray Wells, and Welzel will reach third, second. So a single there for Welzel, and then reaching second on the second Holliston error of the day. Now Jenna Bogan coming to the plate. Welzel 2-for-2 today. There's a strike. 0-1. Kerr delivers, and Bogan trying to poke at that low pitch, 0-2. Jenna Bogan having a nice season at the plate as the lefty will follow this one away. Bogan, a senior, 490 batting average on the season. And she is second on the team in batting average behind Kayla Sullivan, who has a 500. And this is on the ground, third base side, played by the third baseman. Throw to first, and it went off the glove of the first baseman. So Bogan reaches on the error. Bogan also advanced to second, while Welzel advances to third. And Juliet Hulme with two in scoring position and no outs. Getting back to Bogan, she has driven in 19 runs and scored 11. And this is hit in the air, right field, and the basket catch by Brady. The throw home is not going to be in time, just a little late. So a nice catch and throw by Hanna Brady, the right fielder, but not in time. And the seventh Hillers run comes around to score on the sacrifice RBI flyout by Hulme. Bogan advancing to third, and now Nicole Comeau to the plate. And there is a strike. 0-1 on Comeau. To the set. Outside. 1-1. Kerr is set to deliver. Swinging strike. 1-2. To the set. On the ground, up the middle, played by the second baseman. Throw to first in time, but coming around to score is Jenna Bogan. A sacrifice RBI ground out for Comeau. An 8-0 lead for the Hillers. Two outs in the inning. Colleen Mitchell up at the plate. Up high. To the set, swinging strike, 1-1. Fouled away, 1-2. Kerr awaits the sign and deals. This is hit in the air and foul. Count remains 1-2. That was fouled just over our heads. That pitch up high, 2-2. I'd say look out for this Holliston team for the next couple years. They're a young team. This is a pop up, and Kerr gets under it to make the catch for the third out of the inning, but not before. Two more Hopkinton Hillers run score. It's 8-0 heading to the fourth. Just about set for the fourth inning. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate, eliminate your pest problem. WPC Pest is a family-owned business. You can find them online at wpcpest.com. As the Hillers looking for another 1-2-3 inning. defensively. Due up for Holliston is the top of the order. Grace DeZendelet, Heather Ledger, and Shannon Murphy. Except it will not be Shannon Murphy as she was taken out of the game after getting hit with a foul ball. She was the scheduled starting pitcher. So Aaron Kerr took her spot on the mound. We'll see if they keep Kerr in the hit as well. Last time up, Grace DeZendelet struck out. That was back in the first inning. It's been 3-1-2-3 innings for the Holliston Bats. Hume is set to deal. The bunt attempt up the middle. Throw to first in time. Nice job by Comeau. 5-3. One away as Heather Ledger will come up. Hume deals. Swinging strike. Ledger also struck out her last time up back in the first. An 0-1 count. Hume deals. Bunt pulled back. 1-1. Hume set to deliver. That bunt pulled back, but a called strike, 1-2. Hume awaits the sign. To the set. Fouled away. Count remains 1-2. Hume deals. Little bloop shot, that is fair. Bogan will bobble it, and Ledger will reach. So an error there on Bogan, and that'll bring up Aaron Kelley. Sometimes it could be pretty slippery to pick those up. Kelley lined out her last time up. To the set. Down low, and a check by Lizzy Kelley over at first. Ledger back to the bag. Hume set to deal. The bunt pulled back, and the throw to second is going to go over the glove of Welzel, and Ledger advances to third. The throw just late to Comeau. So stolen base for second, and then the error for third. That's what you got to do against a pitcher like Juliet Hulme. Try to manufacture runs. And Hulme takes a walk around the circle as Kelley stepped out of the box. And now the umpire confirming the count. Hume set to deliver. There's a strike. A 2-1 count. Hume deals. Swinging strike, 2-2. Hume to the set, and there is strike three, two away. Six strikeouts so far for Hume. Caroline Werner to the plate, the cleanup hitter, struck out her last time up in the second. Hume deals. just inside. 1-0. Hulme awaits the sign and delivers. There's a strike. 1-1. Hulme set to deal. Up high. Check in at third, runner back, safe. 2-1 on Werner. Hulme to the set, and that'll turn away Werner, a little bit inside there. Werner, a freshman, and the second best hitter in this Holliston lineup. 295 batting average, has scored 10 runs and driven in 4. Look out for Caroline Werner coming up through the ranks of this Holliston softball squad. Impressive numbers as a freshman. And that pitch is in there for a strike, a full count. Hulme gets the sign and deals. And this is hit in the air towards the fence and over the reach of Engstrom. One run scores for Holliston, and that is going to be an RBI double for Caroline Werner. So a rare run given up by Juliet Hulme, and that'll bring up Abby Ray Wells. Wells flew out her last time up. And that just shows you how good of a hitter Caroline Werner is. It's always impressive to see a freshman do that to a pitcher like Juliet Hulme. That pitch inside, 1-0. Hulme deals, fouled away. A 1-1 count. Bunt squared, pulled back, swinging strike. Werner returns the second. Wells, a 216 hitter. She's also a freshman. And there's strike three. So one run scores, but Hulme knots another strikeout, and we will head to the bottom of the fourth. It's an 8-1 Hillers lead. Set for the bottom of the fourth inning. It's an 8-1 Hopkinton Hillers lead. Due up is the top of the lineup. Hanna Engstrom, Renee Cooprider, Lizzy Kelley. Tom Nappy on the call, Bob Hamilton on camera. It's senior night for the Hopkinton Hillers softball team. And so far, they are having a pretty good senior day as they lead 8-1 as Engstrom takes the pitch from Kerr, the bunt squared, strike one. Aaron Kerr set to deliver. And there's a bunt in fair territory, throw to first in time. So 5-3 ground out on that bunt, and that'll bring up Renee Cooprider. Kerr set to deal. That is just high. 1-0. Cooprider is 2-for-2 at the plate today. A pair of singles, has scored 2 runs and driven in a run. There's a strike. 257 heading into this game. That's down low. Has scored 11 runs, once again heading into this game, and driven in 3. That pitch up high, 3-1. Kerr, 0 awaits the sign. To the set, up high. Renee Cooprider draws the walk. So far, in every at-bat, she has reached base. And that'll bring up Lizzy Kelley, who's also having a nice day. She's 1-for-2, but reached on an error in the first. And scored a run, also has a pair of RBIs. And the first pitch is strike one. Oh and one count. And there is ball number one, a little bit outside there. Kerr to the set. This is hit in the air, little bloop shot, and that'll get down and then bobbled by the second baseman and everybody's safe. So Lizzy Kelley reaches. Werner just bobbled it a little bit there. And that was just a little bloop shot. Landed in an awkward position. Debatable if that's an error or not. As the first pitch to Sullivan is a strike. If you think about it, it's interesting. Every time Lizzy Kelley has reached today, it could have been a, if a defensive play was made, or there was a chance to make a defensive play every time she's reached, but she is lucking out today. That pitch down low. 2-1 count on Kayla Sullivan, who's 1-for-2. Has an RBI single and grounded into a double play. And this is a little bloop shot, and it is going to stay fair. And it looked like it was going to bounce foul, but then it bounced right into the catcher, so a single for Sullivan. And everybody pushes up a base, so that means the base is loaded with one out for Kate Welzel. And this is on the ground, third base side. That'll get through, and one run is around to score. A second run being waved around. The third run... runner will be stopped at third base, but two more Hiller's run score. A two RBI hit for Kate Welzel. Renee Cooprider came around to score. Lizzy Kelley also in to score. Kayla Sullivan pushes up to third. A 10-1 lead. Jenna Bogan at the plate. And there's a swinging strike. She lost the bat and fortunately, no one was in the way of that. 0-1. Aaron Kerr set to deliver. That is fouled away. 1-1. Kerr is set to deal. Fouled away. 1-2. Kerr to the set. On the ground, up the middle, that'll get through. One run is in to score. It is 11-1, Hillers. An RBI single for Jenna Bogan. Advancing to third is Kate Welzel. Juliet Hulme now at the plate. And she has a chance right here to get the potential for the mercy call with a big hit. 12-run rule for the mercy called games. That pitch down low, 1-0. Hiller is right now up 11-1. Kerr delivers. This is hit in the air. High fly ball over towards center. Blowing in. And it got past the glove of Ledger. And one run is in to score. Bogan advances to second. And just got there just in time before Ledger was able to get the throw into Werner. And that was tough. The wind definitely took that ball. And I'd say that's a base hit. I don't know if that's an error. The wind really gave that thing a blow and it floated up there. Just a high fly ball. Pretty awkward to play as there's strike one on Comeau. So Bogan at second, Hulme at first. 12-1 Hiller's lead. That pitch up high. Kerr to the set. That pitch is called a strike. 1-2, still only one out in the inning. Kerr deals upstairs. 2-2. Kerr to the set. There's strike three. Two away. They'll bring up Colleen Mitchell. And there is strike one. 0-1. 2 the set. And that is fouled away. 0-2. Another four-run inning for the Hillers. And there's strike three. Two straight strikeouts by Aaron Kerr, but not before the Hillers plate four more runs. It is 12-1 as we head to the fifth. Set for the fifth inning. Hopkinton Hillers leading Holliston 12-1. As the sixth, seventh, and eighth hitters due up for the Panthers. Face Juliet Hulme, who's pitched a terrific game so far. And the one run came after an error by Jenna Bogan. Rare error by Jenna Bogan, I might add. As we are set for fifth inning action, Kate Healy, Elena Ferreira, and Hannah Brady due up for the Holliston Panthers. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by all of our underwriters. We'd like to thank them very much. Also, you can order DVDs of these Hopkinton Hillers games as well, as that pitch is a strike. Visit our website, hcam.tv, or feel free to contact us, 508-435-7887. Right up in the pitch. And that is a little bunt. Throw to first is in time. Nice job by the, nice defensive job by Hulme there. That'll bring up Elena Ferreira. So far, Ferreira has flown out and are only at bat in the third inning. That pitch inside, she'll turn away. 1-1. Hulme to the set. That's down low, 2-1. Hulme delivers. There's a strike, 2-2. Hulme set to deal. And this is a little bloop shot past the reach of Welzel and into center field. The second hit of the day given up by Hulme. That'll bring up Hannah Brady. The right fielder. He said he was making some decent contact with Hume's pitches. But she is certainly still throwing a fantastic game. And that pitch was just unhittable, 0-1. Just to see Hulme even give up a hit, it's just rare. When you see Hulme pitch six or seven games and then you see her give up a hit, it just doesn't look right. That's how good she is. Set the deal to Brady, and the bunt is going to roll foul. 0-2. Hulme set the deal. And this is a little bloop shot right back to the glove of Hulme, and she throws it a first for the double play. How about that? Another nice defensive play from Juliet Hulme to end the fifth inning, the top of the fifth. We head to the bottom of the fifth, 12-1 Hopkinton. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by the dentists at Hopkinton, located at 77 Main Street, providing comprehensive dental care for clients of all ages, from childhood through adult, in a comfortable and relaxing setting. Find them online at hopdent.com. Top of the order, due up for the Hillers. They batted around in the fourth and plated four more runs. It all started with a one-out walk to Renee Cooprider. Lizzy Kelley reached on an error. Kayla Sullivan then singled to load up the bases. Kate Welzel, a 2-RBI double, and then an RBI single by Jenna Bogan, then an RBI hit by Juliet Hulme, and then a pair of strikeouts by Aaron Kerr to get out of the inning. Engstrom 0-2 with a walk, scored a run in the second, and also has a stolen base. And the Hillers with an opportunity here for the Mercy, if they could plate another run. Kerr set to deal, up high. There's a strike, 1-1. The lefty awaits the pitch. Down low, 2-1. Kerr to the set, up high. Kerr set the deal, and there is strike two, a swinging strike. A full count now. And that is down low. Engstrom will draw the walk. Second walk of the day. It'll bring up Renee Cooprider, who's having a nice day. 2-for-2, walked, has scored three runs and driven in one. Kerr delivers, just high. All the seniors wearing the orange and green ribbon in their hair today in the senior night festivities. A pitch up high. Dugout area also nicely decorated. Kerr delivers, and that is hit foul. 2-1. Kerr to the set. On the ground, played by the pitcher. Throw to first, and they do get one, but Engstrom advances to second. That'll bring up Lizzy Kelley. Kerr set the deal, down low. And Engstrom takes off from second. The ball briefly got by Ferrero. So Engstrom advances on the pass ball. And there's a strike, 1-1. So the winning run at third base, or the game-ending run, I should say. That's, of course, if the coaches do put the mercy rule into effect. Kerr set to deliver. On the ground, foul, 2-2. Wind up and the pitch. And that is just outside, full count. Kerr delivers, down low, got by the catcher, and Engstrom will score. And that is going to be the 13th Hillers run. And that is going to do it. Mercy rule is into effect. And the Hopkinton Hillers, another mercy victory, and this time they get it done on senior night, which is always terrific momentum, especially when Thursday you have a game coming up with the very tough Bellingham Blackhawks, the last game of the season that will be here at the Hopkinton Hillers softball diamond. But the Hillers, another terrific job at the plate, another terrific game pitched by Juliet Hulme, and they get the job done. And we'll come back in just a moment and wrap things up. The Hopkinton Hillers get another mercy victory as they take down the Holliston Panthers here on senior day. The final score 13-1. It was a mercy shortened game as the Hillers plated their 13th run in the fifth inning with one out. Lizzy Kelley reached on the error and Hanna Engstrom came around to score on the misfire, and that would be the Hopkinton Hillers' 13th run of the game and put them up by 12 and put the mercy rule into effect. A terrific performance by the Hopkinton Hillers' bats today, and of course, Juliet Hulme. Hulme went all five innings, giving up two hits, one run, which is actually unearned because it occurred after an error that would have ended the inning. No walks, seven strikeouts for Juliet Hulme. So her ERA is going to remain at a .12, which is just miraculous. And for the Holliston Panthers, Erin Kerr pitched today. Shannon Murphy, their scheduled starter, went down in the first as she took a foul ball off the arm. Erin Kerr got the spot start. And the freshman got some great experience facing a very good Hopkinton Hillers lineup. And that'll certainly help her out in the ongoings of her high school softball career. She went five innings, giving up 11 hits, 13 runs, nine of them earned, had three walks, four strikeouts. Let's recap how the Hillers got their runs. Bottom of the first, a one-out single by Cooprider. Then Lizzy Kelley reached on an error. Kayla Sullivan would have an RBI single to score the first Hillers run. Kate Welzel reached on a double. Juliet Hulme, a two RBI single. The Hillers plated four runs in the first. Then in the second, two more were plated. Renee Cooprider, Lizzy Kelley, a couple RBI hits. Then in the third inning, two more runs. A sacrifice RBI flyout by Juliet Hulme. And then a sacrifice RBI groundout by Nikki Comeau. Then four more runs in the fourth inning as Renee Cooprider would walk and Lizzy Kelley reached on an error. Kayla Sullivan then had a single and a two RBI hit by Kate Welzel. Jenna Bogan with an RBI single and Juliet Hulme with the RBI single for the fourth run of the inning. 12-1 at that point, and then Hanna Engstrom came around to score on an error to get things done in the fifth inning, another mercy victory. And the mercy victories are always so key, especially when you know you're going to be having a deep postseason run. You want to rest your starting pitcher. So another key win for the Hillers. The next game will be in just a couple days, the final game of the season. They'll take on the Bellingham Blackhawks. But that is going to wrap up coverage here from the Hopkinton softball diamond, as it looks like now, actually, we'll watch this run out to center field. They're going to do some celebrating, I think, for the
senior night festivities. And it looks like maybe they're going out there for a picture as well as the coaching staff heading out there. But that will do it for this HCAM broadcast of Hopkinton Hillers softball. For Bob Hamilton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for watching. Once again, the Hillers get the victory over Holliston. 13-1 is the final score. We thank you for watching HCAM. Enjoy the rest of your day.